What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to add mods to your Arma 3 server. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. Arma 3 missions are exciting and adventurous, but if you're looking for something more, then you're probably looking for mods. Whether you want silly cosmetics, better movement systems, or brand new scenarios, Arma 3 mods offer a wide range of features. But I have to warn you, the installation process is not for the faint of heart. Installing mods to an Arma 3 server is a game of its own, so if you're ready to jump in and test your mod installing skills, then let's go over how to get started. Before installing and activating Arma 3 mods, you're going to, of course, need to find and download them. Head towards Arma 3's workshop page in Steam, and then use the Browse by Tag section to narrow down all of the mods. If you have a specific mod in mind, you can also use the search field. Once you find the mod that you want to use, just click subscribe on its page, which will download it to your computer. After downloading all of the mods, you can head to your Steam library and find Arma 3, and open it to bring up the launcher. After that, you're going to head to the Mods tab, and then you can either press Load All or separately press each mod. This will create the workshop folder, which is what we'll need in just a minute. And after that, go back to Steam and then right-click the game and hover over Manage and then select Browse Local Files. When the game files open, you'll have to manually enter !!workshop at the end of the Arma 3 directory location. Inside of that workshop folder, you can copy all of the mod files that start with the @ and then paste them onto your desktop or another folder. Then you'll have to rename every other folder that has spaces or special characters. For example, you would have to rename the file Enhanced Movement to Enhanced Movement with no spaces. After doing that, compile all of the mods into a zip folder for the server installation. Once those files are done zipping, you can keep this folder open for later. Now that all of those mods are downloaded and prepared, you can finally head towards your Apex server panel and stop the server. Enter the FTP file access area in the top left, log in, and then on the next page, you can press Upload in the top left corner. Drag and drop the zip file from earlier into the Upload area, wait for this to reach 100%, and then you can push the Back button to return to the main directory of the files. Select the zipped file by clicking the box, then press Unzip in the top right and Submit. Once this is done, you can click on your server name at the top of the page to return to the main panel, and then click Customizations to the left-hand side. Under the Server Settings, input your mods into the Client Mods section using the @ and separating them by a comma. If you only want them for a server and not the client side, then use Server Mods. The client mods tend to be vehicles, maps, or things like that, and the server mods are going to be back-end features. After you've done this, the changes save automatically, so you can click your server name at the top to return to the main panel page, and finally restart the server. Remember that if there are too many mods, or if the file size exceeds a certain amount, then it's going to be hard to do it on our Apex panel. We have detailed tutorials on how to use programs like FileZilla to upload mods instead, which we will have linked down below. If the server isn't starting, this is caused by a failing mod. In these situations, you can confirm this problem in the console from the server panel. You'll see a message that proves that a specific file failed to load, which you can fix by removing the mod and finding another version if you can. In some cases, mods will not work due to missing requirements. For instance, one mod may need another one to properly work. However, it could also just be that a certain mod just doesn't work on servers. You can possibly solve this issue by putting the broken mod names in the Server Mods section from the Customizations instead of the Client Mods. Make sure to restart the server after making any of these changes. If the mods were installed as Client Mods in Customizations, then make sure every player downloaded them onto their computer. Anything that is listed in that client mods section will need to be downloaded by any player that is trying to join the server. It might seem a bit more difficult than other mod installs that we've done, but don't let that stray you away from all of the amazing mods that there are to use in Arma 3. We hope this tutorial made it a little bit easier, and as always, gamers, we hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.